Welcome to Oracle APM tutorial series. In this video, I would like to show you a product demonstration for how you can use Trace Explorer in APM service. My name is Yutaka Takatsu. I am one of the product managers in Observer BTN Management product management team in Oracle Cloud Infrastructure. In this demo, I would like to show you Trace Explorer features. Once you instrument your application with a tracer and upload the data to APM, you can visualize the data in Trace Explorer in Oracle Cloud Console. Trace Explorer allows you to monitor traces and spans and view a large set of data that is collected by different data sources. And you can use that information for slowness detection, troubleshooting, and analysis. The user interface for the Trace Explorer is displayed on the screen. Once the page is loaded, you need to select the compartment and APM domain, because each domain has different data stored. In the upper side of the page, there is a window you can type down a query to extract the desired list of traces and spans. Here you can write your own query, but for your convenience, there are out-of-the-box queries predefined in a quick pickups. These are the queries commonly used by customers. The query result is displayed in the main portion of the page. So you can see the list of traces with the context, such as operation name, status, start time, durations, spans, and error counts. You can see the metrics and dimensions in the field section. They can be used in the query to filter the selection of the data. And you can change the time range, such as last 15 minutes or last 24 hours, or pick a specific range of time and load the data that was collected at the time to the screen. Next, let's see a real-world use case, how you can use Trace Explorer to analyze a performance issue. In the main section of the Trace Explorer, there are traces that were collected in the last 60 minutes. And now I can see some of them are taking very long time. This particular trace at the top row took 30 seconds to execute. If this was your application, likely the next thing you want to do is to find out why the traces were slow. So let's narrow down to see the individual spans within the trace. To see the details of the trace, click the three-dot icon at the end of the row and select to show trace details. It will bring you to the screen where you can see the trace details and the spans of the selected trace. By default, the page displays three sections. From the top of the screen, there is a trace details section, which tells you the trace status, number of service included, number of span contained, trace ID, start time, and the duration. And middle of the page, it shows a topology view, which you can visualize the relation among the services and spans. And the lower side of the page shows a spans view, which is a bar graph showing individual spans with their durations and dependencies. And back in the topology view, currently operation mode is selected. So each icon represents an operation within the trace. There are two different flows in this trace. To see what they are, you can hover the mouse on the icon to see the operation name. So this is an operation that does payment verification. And here is the operation which handles a checkout. And the width of the arrow which connects the icons indicates how much time it took to connect. The wider the size, the slower the connection. So looking at the two flows in the image, you can have an idea that the checkout service in the upper side took longer than the other. You can also switch the server mode to show the topology of the services. By moving your mouse over the arrow, it shows the connection details in a pop-up window. So this is a JDBC call which took 27 seconds to complete. Let's also look at the spans view. In this view, the spans were organized in the order they were called. It basically allows you to see the durations and dependencies of the operations that were captured within the transaction. And the view has bar graphs in a format of Gantt chart, which is a method commonly used to visualize the workflow of the distributed trace. Each bar represents an operation, and the time length go from left to right. So the longer the bar, the more time was consumed to complete the operation. The bar at the top is the root span, and the child spans are nested below. And from the view, you can see the trace was waiting for a SQL operation to complete, which was a bottleneck of this transaction. And to see the details of spans, you can click the bar that opens the span details view, which displays the context information of the selected span. It provides the information such as span ID, span duration, also the attributes of the span. And in this example, the span is JDBC related, so you can see the related database information, including database connection string and also the SQL ID, which may help you to further diagnose the database. Close that. And you can also open thread snapshots from this page by clicking this camera icon. This view visualizes the status of the trace by the snapshots taken for each span. The snapshot contains a code stack information and is by default taken every 250 milliseconds. It is differentiated by the colors indicate the possible wait reasons. So in this example, the first thread is pink, which is waiting for the network, and the second thread is purple, which is waiting for the database. And clicking the icon opens a snapshot details view, which you can drill down to the method, file name, and the line number. And please note that the thread snapshot feature is disabled by default. You can enable it by updating the configuration files. Please see the APM documentation for more details. This concludes the demonstration of the APM Trace Explorer. We have more videos discussing and demonstrating APM features. Please see the description of this video to find links to other APM tutorial videos. Thank you for watching.